Around 1,600 US Army troops arrived in the Washington, D.C. region. The crowd today was reportedly much bigger than yesterday's, with more white middle-class Americans and senators.
Why does Trump got the military out here? Why
does he got... Because he's wrong.
He's racist.
Wrong. He is imposing violence on our people.
In New York, many gathered at Trump Tower. Many more made their voices heard.
Fighting for everybody to be treated equal.
I want them to know my face. I want them to hear my word.
It is about making sure our society works for us all.
With more than 5,600 people arrested nationwide and at least 13 killed in the protests, law enforcement around the country tried empathy.
We heard what you were saying, and it is noted that we're with you.
Let that anger drive you toward a positive change.
And Roxy Washington, mother of George Floyd's six-year-old daughter, Gianna, reminded everyone how unjust the situation was.
I wanted everybody to know that this is what those officers took from. Gianna does not have a father. He will never see her grow up, graduate. He will never walk her down the aisle. If it's a problem she's having and she needs her dad, she does not have that anymore.
President Trump, already heavily criticized for yesterday's photo opportunity in front of a local church, today visited the St. John Paul II National Shrine.
The president now at a Catholic facility, invoking religion once again.
And again, he drew condemnation from religious leaders, with Washington Archbishop Wilton Gregory issuing this statement.
I find it baffling and reprehensible that any Catholic facility would allow itself to be so egregiously misused and manipulated in a fashion that violates our religious principles. So some division here.
Targeting Trump's apparent reluctance to unite the country, presidential candidate Joe Biden chimed in.
The President of the United States must be part of the solution, not the problem.
And still, the people cry.
It's my responsibility to continue to fight for it. Every color and creed in America was tired of police brutality.
It's not something that, you know, just started recently. It's a cup. It's been filling, and it all culminates up to this moment now.
We are humans, and we are Americans who want this country to be the best it can possibly be.
I want justice for him because he was good. No matter what anybody thinks, he was good. And this is the proof that he was a good man.
CBS radio host Michael Williams joins us now from Washington, D.C. Michael, yesterday in Washington, the crowd was tear gassed and shots with rubber bullets were fired to make way for a Trump photo op. Yet today, there were more protesters there despite those actions. Are Trump's actions only inflaming the situation?
They are. I mean, they certainly are inflaming the situation. You know, just the idea that you have a U.S. president who is willing to go to those lengths, to go to that extent just for a mere photo op, it was a very obvious ploy that brought people who may have been teetering on the edge of how am I involved in this and how willing am I to actually go to the street and make my voice heard. The sight of that thing, rather than striking fear into people's heart, it actually emboldened people. So what you saw today were larger and more peaceful protests, more diverse in every way.
You mentioned the crowds are changing. I understand there were more white, middle-class Americans taking part. What do you think this indicates?
What this is really about is just plain and simple justice. People understand that this is something that affects everyone, everyone's life, everyone's well-being. And so they're reacting to it as an issue that isn't just for the other guy. This is for me, too. And if there is only one encouraging thing that comes out of this, it is that finally we may have some sort of uniting issue in this country after such a long period of divisiveness.
Well, yeah, does that suggest that there's a much greater chance of this leading to lasting change, like a broad coalition of people now being concerned about it rather than it just being a black issue?
Yes, I think it does bode well for lasting change. And I think it bodes for lasting change into the elections. Now this is it. People are going to be responding to the candidates' ability and willingness to address issues of fundamental equality and justice in the United States of America. And to me, that is very exciting.
You mentioned the protests are getting more peaceful. We should point out it seems to have been skated over far too much that 13 people have died in the course of these protests and the rioting that's been attached to them. Who are these people, and in what way does it colour what we're seeing at the moment on the streets?
Well, unfortunately, we've seen police officers who have lost their lives. We've seen protesters who have lost their lives. This is the nature of protest, especially at this level. We saw that during the 60s. It is a shame, however, that it has to come to life-threatening situations. We shouldn't have to be losing lives over these issues. We should be spending our time figuring out how to save lives. But those who lost their lives, I believe, are wrapped in glory.
Michael, why do you think Trump insists on visiting religious sites even though people in charge don't want him there?
Well, very simply, he is absolutely convinced, and he is right, that a large part of his voting base is with the religious evangelist fundamentalist section of the vote electorate. He doesn't really care how the religious folks feel about it because he's not really religious. He's really using the church, the Bible literally, as a prop. If he really cared, he'd be meeting with religious leaders. Why not meet with those people instead of standing in front of a church? Why not sit down at a table with religious leaders and understand how to bring those congregations into the table and use those very influential people to help heal and provide answers?
Let's talk about the instincts and tactics of his opponent, Joe Biden. How's he handling the situation?
He's sort of uniquely qualified for this moment insofar as his ability to feel and project empathy. He will say the right things. He will be that comforter in chief that people have been looking for during the Trump administration. And that person is to be found nowhere within the administration, certainly not with the president himself.
There's talk today of Joe Biden attending George Floyd's funeral in Houston on Tuesday. Now, the question, I guess, that leads to, will Donald Trump go? I mean, he's almost damned if he does, damned if he doesn't. But can you imagine Trump going to George Floyd's funeral?
No. Honestly, I can't imagine what that would be like. And remember, this is a president who was disinvited from John McCain's funeral. I think that he would not want to face the type of heat that you would have to face in walking into that situation.
All right, Michael, we'll have to leave it there. But thank you for your time, as always.
It's always my pleasure. Thank you.